Hello everyone, this is Akuchi back with some more Dominion. I'll be playing another match in the World Cup, this time against Silly Potter from Japan. I have not played Silly Potter before, but he's a highly ranked player, so should be a tough match. Japan is the second seed in our group and the biggest threat to advance to the playoffs ahead of USA B. So, see where we go here. I go first with 4 copper. I've got treasure and monastery and trade route for trashing. Smugglers. Trade route is the only plus buy, but I think this looks like probably a single buy game since there's no draw. I mean, well, there's weak draw. We probably want to open in a way to hit 5. Smugglers could be good. Thinking about silver smugglers. I really want to hit 5, but Smugglers is a little less good for me as player one, I think. So City Gate will be pretty good in the early game. Yeah, I might just get City Gate here. I have 9 coins in my deck. So this should guarantee being able to hit 5. Alright, we got a mirror. That's good for me. Okay. We'll pick up Monastery here, I think. I think I prefer that to Trade Route. I don't know. Monastery is pretty bad. We do have City Gate to, like, kind of keep treasure and trade route. Separated. You can trade route fortress. We'll get a monastery. We can always get a trade route later. But monastery can trash more cards. Haggler over treasure, interesting. I think I prefer treasure. But I'll happily pick up a Haggler given the opportunity here. I think. Alright, pick up a Fortress. We should take the key or not. Probably not. Okay. So I need to top deck the estate if I want to buy a haggler, which I think I do. Arena points don't seem super important. So smuggler does fail to gain platinum. I think it's probably correct for at least one of us to play with smugglers. But I'm not gonna complain. That looks good. Okay. I think I'll top deck the fortress. Pick up fortress moat. Yeah, I don't think this is a double treasurer kind of board. One seems fine. So, treasure and haggler together are 5, silver 7. So, if I have 2 copper in hand along with all those, I can afford platinum. So, I don't need to buy gold. Also, the key could help. A second treasure is not bad, but I think we'll just go with fortresses. So we've got one estate left. Silly Potter has 2. Probably has the monastery in hand, though. Well, we actually can pick up a platinum here. Hopefully we draw a copper. Then I'm happy to take the key here. Okay, good. Right, so what card do I want other than platinum? We have quite a few. Oh, interesting. There's a treasure or monastery synergy. Where you can pick up copper and then trash it to monastery. I think that does make me lean towards a second treasurer. Definitely need to pick up the pace on these moats. That's nice. But he still hasn't trashed his copper. Do I want to trigger? I think so. It's a little unfortunate. Might have terminal collision. Yeah, maybe we just end here, pick up a moat. Yeah, it seems fine. So now we are free of the estates. I definitely want to get some more fortresses. He's in a position to win that 6-4. Maybe I've only trashed 2 copper. Seems likely. Gold, okay. Alright. Take the key or trash? Maybe I just resign myself to having 4 fortresses. I think we'll wait. I mean, yes, we will resign ourselves to having 4 fortresses, if that's what he wants. Okay. Yeah, I think I can. I'll just discard the moat. Take the key, trash monastery. Seems good to me. Do I want a trade route? Nah, I think that's too greedy. I think we'll just get colonies now. Still got 2 estates. Okay, I can top deck the fortress. Take the key, buy colony, trash copper. I think I have 3 moats to his 2. So he just has a lot of fortresses right now. So the good news here. That's pretty nice. Darn. I need to take a copper to afford colony. That's not great. So the alternative is we take a platinum. We're ahead on the arena points, so kind of ahead that way. Yeah, I think I'll do that. So we can take the key or we can trash. Taking the key makes his turns worse, but I like this opportunity to trash. That's a lot of fortresses. That's not quite what I want to see. Hopefully, I at least see some moats. He has one estate left. I have at least one copper, possibly two. My guess is he has one copper and one estate left, and I have two copper left. That's my guess. This is not looking good. We still don't have enough for colony. Oh my goodness. Oh boy. This is unfortunate. Province gold, I guess. Yeah, this is looking unfortunate. We have a lot of platinums in there. and a lot of moats. Thinking about trade route though. I'm actually going for it. All these platinums. Could just top deck a fortress though. Think I like that. So we'll see how well we province dance. That's a lot of fortresses. I just misunderstood the situation. I'm just losing. Interesting. Well, this is a lot of coins. Wow. Okay, so if he takes. Do I just like buy a colony and there the hope that he can't? Is that my best play? So if he buys. Yeah, unfortunately, I see all my treasures here. So if he takes a colony, he's up to 54. If I take a province, I'm at 40. Do have the trade route, but it seems really unlikely that I can win if he takes two colonies. And like, or that if he takes just one colony here. He has a lot of platinum though. I need him to miss at least once over the next two turns. Should I gamble that he misses this turn? It's really bad to see my two treasures here. I don't even think I can colony next turn. Have the trade route. Maybe he plays scared of the trade route. We can always hope. So ideally, I see my trade route and can trash the monastery. Yeah, he's got the key. Well, we'll see what happens here. We can't even. Can't even afford a province here. That is tragic. I shouldn't have even done that, but whatever. We had one critical miss earlier in the game, and that was that. That should be game. And I'll continue to use the country letters for the results here. That was my start, unfortunately. Oh boy. Wow, 0% donate. This looks miserable. I think we open. Yeah, there's no village, right? Yeah, this is awful. Guess we open Potion Ambassador? Like to open Moneylender, but without a village, I don't think that's a good idea. Guildhall. Want to get that kind of early. Yeah, ultimately we just need treasures here. That's the payload. Oh, did he have a 5-2? That's good news for me. That's good news for me. That's bad news for me. Ambassador misses the shuffle. Probably get a church. Don't like it though. Just make it. Okay, return one estate. Interesting. Interesting choice. I don't know about this church. A little concerned. I think I'll get a silver. Now, let's get a church. Not the best of hands. In particular, because of how bad it's going to make my apothecary. Really like to Guildhall. Got some estates here. How do I have 3 VP? Oh man, already wall. Already wall. Darn. I was hoping I'd see the Guildhall thing. I think this is worth Guildhall. Like, yeah, I want gold and stuff, but I'll get them later. He just doesn't have cards in his deck. It's a pretty good spot to be. Yeah, look at this. He just doesn't have a deck. Okay. Guess I'll set aside nothing. Buy one more apothecary. guess I could also delay the ambassador, but I don't like that. So I get a church or a silver. This looks pretty hopeless. My ambassador missing was pretty awful. I have three estates in my deck. Let's return two estates. I think I'll buy a gold here. Is silver better? So I have two extra coffers with the silver. Just kind of like a spices situation. I mean, there is fairgrounds. This game might go on for a while. Get a gold. Need this potion anymore. Think I'll trash it. So if we do end up going for fairgrounds, I'm getting up to four easy enough, I think. Getting up to 6 doesn't seem worth it. Yeah, let's trash the potion. Wonder if I just go for a province right now. And forum, yeah, there's wall. Oh, I guess I could have returned 2 copper and bought a gold. That would have made a good deal of sense. Yeah, that would have been better. Probably. So I think we're hurt by 2 wall points. Our opponent, meanwhile, has an extremely thin deck. Go 4 gold. That'd be pretty reasonable, I think. Province also reasonable. We could just stop drawing right now. That's a really terrible turn. So you get a province here, and something that's not a province next turn. Possibly nothing. Or you could get a gold here. Also, we need to return some coppers, to be honest. Like, that's quite a lot of points. So we could return 2 coppers. Could buy a moneylender. I'll try that. Okay, so we have 17 cards. That's how we count. Yep, we're in a rough spot. Don't think we want to buy a copper. Think that'd be foolish. So we could return 2 copper here and still buy a province. If we did that, we'd have 17 VP. That's our best bet. We just hope he can't play Ambassador. Somehow. He's not even. He doesn't even have a deck size of 14 yet, or 15 yet. Oof. That's rough. Yeah, I don't even think we can tie. Because if he buys a province, he's at 24. The best I can do is 23. Nah. He found it. Well, this is going poorly. Down 0-2. What is this? Bustling village, only village. Envoy patron is something. We have a 5. That's awful. But settlers is fine. So there is like Mill Diplomat. But I think we begin with a patron. And then we can get a Devil's Workshop. Settlers are pretty good here, though, with Mill. That's a pretty interesting board. Think we can make this work. There's Bishop for extra VP. But Devil's Workshop as a gainer doesn't really work once we start having plus buy. I mean, it gains imps, which are fine. But not for Bishop food. So yeah, I think our next four is probably Mill. Think that's, I mean, we could go with Diplomat as well, but I think I prefer a Mill here. No, Devil's Workshop, yeah. Having a villager or two from patron is very nice. Very nice indeed. Not in a real rush to get more patrons. I think I prefer mills. That's pretty cool. Do we want a gold? Wow, we have three estates in those seven cards. That's. And no mill. That's inconvenient. I don't think gold helps us hit Grand Market much more than mill. Wow, two estates top decked. I think that's pretty good, but I mean, I didn't need all the money last turn. I don't need more than two this turn. So, a little unfortunate. So, let's go ahead and get Diplomat here, though. Yeah, maybe that diplomat is not great. We won't get any more because we're gonna be able to get villages. Go ahead and get an envoy now, I guess. Dang. Yuck. So we play patron into diplomat here, I guess. Oh my gosh. Come on. Oh great, now I have a mill. Come on. Let's get these bustling villages. They seem really good. Maybe he's got more envoys. Maybe that was a mistake. Draws could have gone better. Huzzah. Okay. That's a really nice hand. That's a really nice hand. I think he can afford a grand market, though. But two devil's workshops, that's pretty nice. Feel ahead. Indeed, I believe I'm behind. I like having the three bustling villages, though. Probably get one more envoy than a bishop in terms of my four cost gains. We want at least two grand markets. Horse traders, huh? Envoy, huh? Interesting. That is so bad. That is such bad luck. All these cards that are a lot better than the cards I had in my hand last turn. Dang it. Thank you. Maybe just the one grand market we'll have to do. I wonder if he can get to this patron again. I doubt it. I don't think I want him to have villagers. Hopefully he doesn't draw the bustling village. Yeah, horse traders is fine as plus buy. Maybe I should have considered the Double Devil's Workshop. Dang it. Yeah. You can just play that again. I don't really want him to get a bunch of coffers. Huh. Well, maybe a coffer. Maybe I'd rather give him a coffer than I would a villager. If he plays Envoy again, I can just discard it again. Well, how many settlers has he played? He's played both of his settlers. He only has a 1 mil. He's gonna want to play horse traders. On the other hand, envoy account. Those are all his envoys. So, could leave him with those three cards on top. I know they're not a bustling village, and I know they're not an envoy, so they're not great. Oh, I didn't even notice he had two patrons. I am losing this game. Huh, interesting. Discards a mill, okay. I think there's time for bishop, unfortunately. How many imps does he have? He has three. Oof, that's a tough choice. Imp or envoy? That's an easy choice. Got one villager. He might have his two bustling villages and those six cards. That seems like the case. So that's bad news for me. Yeah. Pretty hopeless. Well, we are doing terribly here. none of this really matters. Man, this is going horribly. Wonder what mistakes I made. Wow. Maybe he has a terrible shuffle and I'm somehow managed to win. I like him using that coffers. I mean, if he hits my grand market, of course. That's going to be awful. Can I actually like seed good cards in there? Not really. Yeah, I think better to play the patron. Well, not really. That's too bad. Mill. Think Mill. Sure, we'll discard. Okay. So do we get that mill or not? So he's gonna get, if he gets two mills, can we win? He'd be up to 45. Not really. So let's assume he gets one mill. He said, well, unless I get bishop or something. So I go up to 1st. I think we need bishop to win. Whoa, I just didn't think about that at all. I did not think at all. That mill, that'll probably do the trick. He has zero actions, though, right? Wow. Okay. Yeah. Wait. I don't want to discard because I don't really need the coins, and I'd rather find that bishop if possible. What am I going to bishop, though? Do I bishop a patron? Suppose I could. I don't think I have the win, right? Wait, do I have the win? It is a miracle. Wow. That was crazy. USA. Got a quick break. And I am back. So we're up, I mean, we're down 1-2, and we've started two out of the three games, so it's definitely an uphill climb from here. But we need to win 2.5 out of the remaining three games to get a match win, and two out of the remaining three to get a match tie. The latter sounds far more doable, but we're gonna try. Been a pretty long match so far. Three games in 1 hour and 20 minutes. Ah, here we are. Got chapel. Acting troop has only plus actions. No plus by except druid. There's seer and masterpiece. Seer tunnel. This is an interesting one. Museum and tower. Tower is definitely relevant. There's quite a lot of points that aren't provinces. So we open with chapel and silver, I guess. I'm trying to get seer if possible. I wonder how important it will be. The acting troops. I've got seer for a lot of draw, but it's definitely nice to be able to play some oracles. Like we're both gonna get pretty good draws. Yeah. I was able to trash two estates and buy Seer. I think he'll be able to do the same. Not quite. But still pretty good. Ooh, this looks absurdly good. This is actually insane. I'm guaranteed to draw everything except for one copper. And I might draw a copper. Okay. Yeah, this is really good. Wonder what this means. So I could trash two copper, buy an acting troop. It would give me enough coins to buy a seer next turn. Okay. Do we just get a druid though? So we have our seer here. So, how many cards are we guaranteed to draw? So, we're gonna see four guaranteed. One, two, three, four. So we could trash two copper and buy a druid. We could get. Our hand size would be five. No, it'd be four. Well, we could discard the acting troop. So then we could get. A gold and a patrician. Yeah, let's give that a try. Needs to trash some copper, but he doesn't have an acting troop, so he has to choose between druid or chapel. Patrician seems really good here. I think that'll be at like tower points. I mean, Seer will also, but. Maybe that's foolish. Just getting a bunch of patricians here doesn't really help my deck. Probably want to get at least one silver. Maybe two silvers. Two silvers and a patrician. No, maybe one silver and two patricians. Seems a little safer. Well, I might not be able to buy us. Let's go with two silvers. And one patrician. It's a little dangerous. do we get? Oracle instead. I don't think so. Okay, this looks really good. I mean, we have our seer in our starting hand, so of course it's good. He has not trashed those coppers. I feel like that's gonna hurt him a little, but not much. Not at all. All right, so Seer and Patrician are gonna pile. Patrician Emporium. Not sure what else is going to pile. Yeah, I have a gold that I can draw with Patrician. Oh, that's some nice gain in play. Man, that's annoying. That is extremely frustrating. Why you gotta be like that? Dang it. That's real bad. Alas. Top deck's a gold, okay. Do have another seer in there. Along with silver. We don't need any gain and play stuff. Yeah, actually, we just want to leave the seer on top. Now, this is a little bit annoying, though, because we. We need to play five to get the points from Emporium. Yeah, that's probably worthwhile. Yeah, we just want to play him. What do we get here? We could get like tunnel, oracle, Got a lot of options. I think we just want to get provinces though, once, like mostly provinces once Emporiums are gone. So I think I actually want to try to get a gold into Emporiums if I can. I like having these patricians. Obviously, it's nice to have seers too. Wow. Anyway. Oh, and he gets to trash his coppers now. But I will happily take the last two Emporiums if he takes two. My deck is a little better at greening with provinces on account of my patricians. He has three copper left. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. That's pretty scary. Cool. That is pretty scary. So I definitely don't. Reveals a silver. So I could discard. Yeah, I can like seed my next turn nicely. That seems pretty cool. Or I can just save a villager. That also seems pretty good. We could gain and play a druid. Maybe I need to do that. He's got four seers in his next hand, okay. Oh, I could have discarded a silver. That was dumb last turn. Okay. That definitely looks unfortunate. Decks of copper, okay. Top decks of gold. All right. Do we just have two more turns left? Seems plausible. I think we get one Emporium, and then we get as many like provinces as we can. Or like province tunnel or something. Yeah, let's see if we can get. We could get a tunnel right now. Think I want to get a gold. Can use this turn. I think that's the best I can do. So 12 plus 18, 19. It's enough for province duchy. Or we could get an oracle. Let's go with province duchy, I guess. I don't know. Thinking about Oracle Tunnel instead. Yeah, let's try that. Is there a nice starting hand? Because I'm hopeful that I can get Masterpiece Emporium next turn. This looks like a ridiculously good turn. Holy crap. Look at that. Wonder if he just has it here. Probably. So that's 17 coins. Yeah, he just needs 22 coins, which I'm sure he has. So we cannot win anymore. Best we can do is tie. I did not see that masterpiece approach. I guess I could have left an Emporium. Played that well. Sonavanto, Altar, Monastery. Have it trashing. The only draw is Den of Sin, so we want to win that as hard as we can. We have a 2/5. Well, okay. Thinking about Legionary though. Legionary is definitely an attack I want to play, right? Maybe not. It is the easiest way to continue to get like 5 and 6. I don't really like a den here. I mean, the other draw is Savanto. But it's kind of awkward. So I think we're gonna go with Legionary here. Alright, now we can den, which is great. We can just ride the dens all the way. Wow, so he rolled high there. I don't like it when that happens. You know? It's pretty upsetting. I don't think Nomad Camp openings should be rewarded. I think they should be punished. Alas. Alas. And he sees his altar. Amazing. I'm not destined to win. I don't even know if I want altar. At this stage. Maybe. But I don't have a denizen in hand. There's no chance. Well, the only way I can get a Denison next turn is if I see that altar. Yeah, I don't think I can get it. Well, maybe that's okay, right? So I need to get at least two Denisons. But once the Den of Sins are gone, what do I do with the altar? I'm not sure. I could get Sana and Silver, but I'm not going to need more trashing at that point. Plus buys Terminal. It's all really awkward. Now, if we miss 5 after this, I mean, well, we're just really sad, but. It's not too uncommon either. Not too unlikely at this point. We have 4 copper. We need to draw either 2 of them or we need to see our legionary. We have 3 cards that we don't want to draw unless we draw a legionary. Yeah, it's pretty rough. Just all worked out for Silly Potter this game. It's actually amazing. Like, look at how well this is working out. All right. Gold would be greedy. Let's not be greedy. Greed is good. All right, so we win the Den of Sin split. That makes me happy. We don't need the copper or the estate. I'm gonna hold on to the estate. Right? No, let's not tempt fate. What if we had bottom decked our legionary? Still would have been fine. Oh well. Yeah, so we're just gonna buy provinces after we get this gold. Ideally, we would have trashed one more card, but then it would have been like perfect. Instead, we're gonna have one card we don't draw each turn, and if it's a Den of Sin, that's gonna really mess us up. Can also salt. Yeah, I think I'll just let him get all, go after all those saunas himself. If that's what he wants. I mean, his deck is definitely coming together. If only we had seen our monastery one more time. Oh wow, three dens. Would have been real slick deck. And as it is, we might work. We just need to keep getting lucky with what we bottom deck. Really, we want to bottom deck copper every turn. That's gonna. Or province. Some point, that's gonna not work. Interesting. Sigh. Do I have time to buy one more gold? I think so. Yeah, I think so. That way, a gold being bottom decked is another tolerable outcome for a little while. Yeah, we didn't attack though. Once he gets one Avanto, all of a sudden he can play two actions per turn. With two Avantos, he can play three actions per turn. If it all works out, which it probably will. Uh-oh. I don't want to be attacked. That attack didn't seem to do much at all. Need at least two more turns. Kinda need to buy province here, and then if I can buy province here, should be in pretty good shape. So he's got one gold, one silver. One legionary, one nomad camp. Two copper. So I'm kind of saying I need to draw my other gold. I need the Den of Sin, I think. Well, I'm not sure. So if we discard the Den of Sin, we guarantee that we can buy province this turn. Think that's what we want to do. Ooh. Interesting. Don't think he can get enough non-province VP here. We'd need three duchies and an estate and to trash the curse. Maybe you can do that, actually. No, I don't think he has the gains. Getting destroyed. That was my start, too. Destroyed. Play a game, please. Five, two, come on. He actually has a 3-4. This is a really nice shuffle. Obviously, his captain's gonna bottom deck, and I'm gonna reveal it with Jester. The single copper. What does it portend? Got a second copper down. My crossroads missed. All of a sudden, not so good. I do want more captains, but I don't know if fairy is the way to get it. I can use pageant instead. That's another way to get captain. Which to play as a cantrip? Jester, I think. Maybe Enchantress. Let's push our luck. Could do Captain as Crossroads. It's pretty good. I guess I'll gain that. Not tremendously excited about it, though. There's a limit to how many captains I want. And I may have hit the limit. Maybe I haven't quite hit the limit. Could place storeroom here to get rid of the two copper. Not too exciting. Could end up swindling a captain. For him, that would swindle it into a four cost. Like a temple or research. I don't know, they're terrible though. They're pretty bad though. Some pretty exciting stuff going on. That's too bad. Okay, so we could play yet another Crossroads. Yeah, I don't see why not. I'm gonna get one more gold. And then I'll start getting provinces. How many copper I've trashed? Not too many. I think we'll probably store room here with our first captain. Guess I could have bought a captain there instead of a gold because we had played two captains that turn. Still concerned about terminal space. In general. Wow. Been swindled. Swindled. Certainly a lot of captains. Okay, I think we will. That's kind of awkward. Maybe we can make this work though. Yeah, I think this will work. Could play it as temple. Bring us down to 11 coins. As opposed to going up to 14 coins. Yeah, let's start getting some provinces. Sweet. Definitely one province. Maybe I get the last captain just in case it's swindled into gold or something. Yeah, let's do it. This has been an unreasonably good jester, by the way. Yeah, so if I get attacked by Enchantress with only one captain on the mount, I can't do any storeroom stuff, so this hand is looking pretty bad. It's a lot of swindlers. Unfortunate. Oh no, we can do that. I think it's worthwhile to do a storeroom here. I think I'll actually toss the captain too. Cool. I mean, we definitely didn't do much that game or that turn. But we got two captains in play, or three. Three captains in play and an enchantress. Let's try to set up enchantresses. The swindlers haven't done a whole lot of good. That cannot be denied. Oh my gosh, they've done like nothing. Yep, seems reasonable. Cool, that's really nice. So, I actually have all my green cards in hand. So I don't really need to play storeroom here. I'm a little scared to play Swindler. So I think we're gonna start with a priest. I am scared. I guess I'll just do storeroom now. Nah. Priest or temple? I think temple's a little better here. Oh, I could have done a smart thing there. Maybe? No, I don't think so. Do I get two provinces? guess not. That could have been better. Oh well. Maybe Temple was incorrect there. Give him a gold. I mean, obviously, if Swindler hits Province, then he can win. And that's not unlikely at all. He needs to play one captain in a storeroom. The other two can be swindlers if he wants to try for the win. You can get two provinces even without swindling. That might be, I mean, I don't think that's enough, but it's kind of close. That's a bit annoying. Ooh, that's great. Been very lucky with the Swindler hits. Trouble is, I need to be pretty careful about playing Swindler if he does buy two provinces. I may need to play one of my captains as a crossroads. Well, I know what I need to do. Okay, that's nice. Don't I have one more captain, though? I think I do. So I think I can discard. Alright, so what do I need? I need to be able to buy province, duchy. That sure does seem difficult. Okay. Should be able to make this work, right? Just discard a bunch. That's like a gold there. Yeah. So my terminals are Captain Crossroads, Captain Jester. I don't think Jester can hurt me in any way. But I might want to keep it in my hand. Yeah, I don't need it, so. Captain is storeroom. Discarding the Enchantress, I draw a gold, and I can discard five cards. Do that. Play Jester. And play this as a storeroom. That's a wrap. So we ended up 2-4. Apologies, America. Hopefully the rest of USAB gets a favorable record over Japan, and we're able to get that first seed. Next match will be against Western Europe, I believe. Until then.